different kinds of habitats. Now that's an interesting word there, habitats. Actually, let's get into that right away with the word habitat. So habitat is a place where animals live, where an animal lives. So a habitat is talking about, you know, the environment, the surrounding. If an animal lives in a forest, that's a type of habitat. Or if an animal lives in a desert, that's a different type of habitat, right? We talk about us, you know, do you like to live in the city? That's a type of habitat. Or in the country? That's another type of habitat. So there are many different kinds of habitats, and in this lesson, we are going to talk about different habitats and different words to describe the habitats about where animals live. Okay, let's take a look at a video of a special kind of habitat. What can we say about this habitat? We can see this bird here. Where does this bird live? We can see water here. Looks like maybe a river or a lake. We have a lot of vegetation, plants growing in the background. So we can see that this bird here, this is mama bird, right? These are her babies. What is mama bird doing? She really seems to be caring more about her appearance than about her babies. She's really fixing her feathers, or maybe she has an insect in there and she's trying to get that insect, I don't know. But anyway, obviously these birds live here. This is their home. This is where the babies hatch. That's where they're growing up. This type of habitat with all the water around and the plants and the trees, we could call that a wetland, okay? It's a wetland. There's another type of habitat we can talk about, and we can see, well, this is a very special looking type of forest here. A forest, of course, is an area where there are many trees, okay? So in a forest, you can't really see very far because there's so many trees. A forest is an area with many trees and plants, but really it's trees that make a forest. Now this is kind of a special forest. This is probably in Northern California where we have these huge redwoods. Okay, it could also be in Australia. They also have very tall trees in Australia. I'm not sure where this picture is from, but this is kind of a special forest, isn't it? We don't really have these kinds of big trees in most forests. Most forests have the smaller trees like this one over here. But a forest is just an area with a lot of trees. Different types of animals will live in different types of habitats. Forests, we'll talk about what kinds of animals live in these different areas later on. Okay, so we looked at forests, but there's another type of forest that's a little special, right? It's called a rainforest, right? A rainforest, of course, is different from a normal forest because of rain. It rains a lot, right? So a rainforest is a forest in an area where it rains a lot. So this type of forest, people can also say it's a jungle, right? Jungle. Especially if the jungle is in a hot, humid area. That's a jungle. We find jungles in South America and Africa. If it's further north, right, further north, but it still rains a lot, we can still call it a rainforest. Maybe not so much a jungle because the jungle is really hot, but it's a rainforest. And this is a special area where it gets a lot of rain. The plants are really, really thick, and there's a lot of different animals that live in rainforests. The amount of animals and types of animals that live in a rainforest is really great. A lot of different variation, a lot of different species live in a rainforest. Let's take a look at a video here. We can see a video here of a rainforest, and we can kind of see, you know, this vapor. What is this stuff? This is vapor. It's like mist. It's so humid there that the water is in the air. We can see it moving around on top of the water here. We can see very, very green, very, very dense, very thick plant growth. And that's what a rainforest is like. So lots of water, lots of plant growth, and it's hot and it's very humid. There's a lot of moisture in a rainforest. Okay, we'll move on. This is a completely different type of habitat. On one side we have rainforest, lots of rain. On the other end, the opposite end, we can have a desert, no rain, or very, very, very little rain. And we call this, of course, a desert. We see a picture of a desert here. Well, one of the more famous animals that live in a desert is a camel, right? Camels live in deserts because they can store their food and water in the hump on their back. So they can survive for a long time without water. And a desert is a place that gets little or no rain. So camels are adapted to live in the desert. They can live in the desert because they have adapted to the climate in the desert, the fact that there is little or no rain there. Okay, so that's a desert. Wow, this is very exciting. We have dolphins here, right? And the dolphins live in the ocean. Of course, you know what the ocean is. An ocean is a very large area of salt water. Salt water, very important. Because if it's fresh water, it's not an ocean, okay? Fresh water, if you have a large body of fresh water, that is a lake, not an ocean, okay? A large body of fresh water is a lake. Like you have in America, you have the big lakes, the Great Lakes. They're fresh water, not salt water. If it's salt water, we call it an ocean. Now, these dolphins live in the ocean. Of course, they live in the water. They're just having fun. That looks like a lot of fun right there, doesn't it? They're just coming out of the water. But of course, they live most of their lives in the water. Okay, very exciting picture. That's an ocean. Okay, we also have a very special type of habitat, and that is called the Arctic. The Arctic. The Arctic is an icy and cold place near the North Pole. The Arctic is in the North Pole. Antarctic is the South Pole. But we are talking about the Arctic here. Polar bears live in the North Pole. Polar bears don't live near the South Pole. Similar conditions, North Pole and South Pole, right? But in the Arctic, it's special. There is no land under the ice. No land. It's just ice. That ice never melts. Oh, some of it does, sure, but most of it never melts right at the top of the North Pole. So this polar bear is walking on ice. Underneath the ice is water, no land. That's how cold it is, that the ice stays frozen all year round. Now, of course, it shrinks in the summertime and it grows in the wintertime. It does go like this. So some ice does melt, but a lot of it never melts. Okay, so that's very interesting. If we take a look, it's very cold up there. Can you imagine what life is like for the polar bear there? Does he look cold? He doesn't look that cold. Actually, he's kind of big, right? Polar bears are big animals. But look at the fur on that polar bear. He has a really big coat, a really thick fur of hair. And that's what keeps him warm. Even though he lives up in the Arctic, you know, he stays warm because he's got such a good coat of hair on. He stays warm there. He doesn't look cold. He's just kind of like shuffling along like ordinary bears do. You know, and they usually eat seals under the ice. That's what they hunt. Okay, it was too cold in the Arctic. Let's move on to a wetland. A wetland is a special type of habitat because it's a mixture of water and plants or a little bit of land. A wetland is an area covered with water and plants. So wetland, sure, there's water there, but the land is not too far underneath the water. The water is not very deep. The water is usually shallow in a wetland for most of the wetland. And you could probably walk out there. The water would come up to your legs or maybe your hip or your waist up here. But you could probably walk out there because the plants are growing in the ground just under the surface of the water. And this is a wetland. A wetland is very, very important for many birds. Birds who will fly by, they will come down here. And this is a very, very good habitat for many types of birds like ducks and geese and swans. Birds will come here and they'll be able to swim around, find food, and it's a very good habitat. Not just for birds, but for many other types of animals. And a lot of animals will live in this type of habitat. Okay. Another type of habitat is a grassland. Now, grassland, of course, there's lots of grass, but there's no water right here, right? If there's water, it's under the ground, right? You will not get wet if you go walking along a grassland. But another point about a grassland, there are no trees. So it's not a forest, it's open grassland. You can see for very far. Grassland is a large, flat area with a lot of grass. So the characteristics about grassland, no trees, it's flat, so you don't have mountains or hills. And it's large, it's a large area, it's flat, and it has a lot of grass. What lives there? Well, in the American West, a long time ago, buffalo lived on the grassland. Antelope live in the grassland. Deer live in the grassland. Lots of different animals will come by and eat the grass, okay? And they can roam and run around free without any barriers like trees or mountains or hills, okay? So that's a grassland. Now, we also have a word here. This is not a habitat, but it's kind of, it's a verb, to cover. To cover something means to give it shelter and make it safe. So what kind of animal is this? Kind of a kyopji animal, right? Cute. It's a cute little crab here, and this is a special type of crab. It's called a hermit crab, a hermit crab. So this animal is a hermit because he lives alone. He's a hermit crab. And they're very cute. You probably have seen these before. Maybe you've had one as a pet before. I don't know. But the crab will go inside the shell. And when it gets too big, what does he do? He leaves that shell and he picks up another shell and goes into that, right? So hermit crabs are very interesting. They cover their bodies with a shell made by a different animal, right? You can't really call this a habitat, but it's just a shell that covers the animal. A habitat is the area where an animal lives. This is just a shell. It covers the hermit crab. So some animals will cover themselves with things in the environment, like a hermit crab. Very, very smart little crab, isn't he? Okay.
Lesson 6. Where animals live. Habitat. A habitat is a place where an animal lives. Forest. A forest is an area with many trees and plants. Rainforest. A rainforest is a forest in an area where it rains a lot. Desert. A desert is a place that gets little or no rain. Ocean. An ocean is a very large area of salt water. Arctic. The Arctic is an icy and cold place near the North Pole. Wetland. A wetland is an area covered with water and plants. Grassland. Grassland is a large flat area with a lot of grass. Cover. To cover something means to give it shelter and make it safe.